Legends.
But now, that was the past for the Sharks, but yep. Now we're moving into the future.
The future.
The future. Ooh. So now now, as you were saying, I shouldn't say bought out. Why should I not say bought out?
No, bought out makes it sound so... It's like it's dead captured. You make it sound so captured. You know, you make it sound so... I'm not gonna say things that would, you know, mm-hmm. I'm not trying to incriminate myself. But however, you know... Yeah. I understand, you know, the conversations around, you know, the MVN coming in and people just thinking that, you know, the Sharks now are being ran by an American company. It's a story of sports.
Mm.
And the thing, what's this? Man United owners, I think.
They're American.
They're American.
Yeah.
You know, I think at some point, I think Newcastle at some point wanted to be bought by, or they are currently, I'm not sure. Comment down below and make sure that I get that right. And yeah. You know, it's a thing that's been happening there. And I mean, look, it's great for me personally. It's great. Everyone is excited about, you know, having a millionaire or a billionaire. You know, I know his the owner of the MVN. He I think he's an old boy of Kensington or sorry of Kingsway or something. Mm. Correct me once again. But he's South African, obviously made his fortune out there and above. And he came back and let's be honest, we all know that he wanted to buy to buy into the Western Province, but that deal didn't really, that collapsed. And then, you know, they went for the Sharks. But now it's great. I feel like this is what every team would want this to happen. Unfortunately, not for the Western Province, but it's great for the sports. It's great for the image of the team itself and the players and the potential players that they might have.
Oh, no, I agree with you. Because you have to understand now that sports is a business.
Like, at the end of the day.
Like the Sharks, cool, they have employees. It's not just, hey, they go on the field, play rugby. There's a business. There's a financial statement that needs to be corrected.
And it's a balance.
With an American company and having other people, like they have had sports franchises. They've been a thing of American millionaires, billionaires buying sports franchises.
Yes.
And absolutely like... being involved in the business structure of it. Because the Sharks, we are still a young, like, company, if you want to look at it.
In a way,
started in 95.
Rich history, but in recent years, I mean, it's not as massive as the Blue Bulls. It's not as massive, you know, as probably maybe a Western province, I think, in a way. But it's not so big, but it was effective when it came in and it could only do as much. So every team needs a bit of an injection. And whether it comes in a form of a donation from the government, when it comes in a form of a millionaire investing in the business, it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
You know, they need to also compete in the markets of transfer activities. They need to make sure that that happens. Mm. When they go, they start their Pro 14 journey in April or beyond, they need to compete.
Mm.
You know, you can't just go and play against Munster and think that, you know, on any other day, Jaden Hendricks would do everything for you. You'd want to compete in the market and go in Europe and make sure that you get everything over the line. So it's great, man. For me, it's perfect.